Welcome. In this video, we'll see some of the remaining logical instructions present in 8051. So the first instruction is CLRA. So CLRA stands for clear the contents of accumulator. So let us put some value in accumulator. For example, here we have taken 5A as the value. So if when I execute this instruction, the value present in accumulator will become 00. So this is the value 5A. Right now present in accumulator. So if I execute that instruction, the value becomes 00. Next instruction is CPLA. So using this instruction, we can complement the contents of accumulator. So if the bit is 0, that bit will become 1. And if bit is 1, that bit will become 0. So value present in accumulator is 5A. So if I execute that instruction, the value becomes A5. So which is the complement of 5A. Next instruction is RLA. So RLA instruction is used to rotate the value present in accumulator to the left side by 1 bit position. So let us assume again the value present in accumulator as 5A. So if this is the value and if I rotate the value on left side by 1 bit, it means that this MSB bit, that is 0, that will go to the LSB. And all the bits will be shifted on left side by 1 bit position. So the new value in accumulator will be 10110100, that is nothing but B4 hex. So let us check the output. So we have got here B4 hex. Next instruction is RLCA. So RLC stands for rotate the value present in accumulator to the left side through carry. Now in the previous instruction, it was directly rotating the value from MSB to LSB, but in this instruction, the MSB bit, that is 0, that will be copied to the carry flag, and the status of carry flag will be copied to the LSB bit. So let us assume there that the carry flag is 1. So I will make that carry flag 1 over here. So let it be 1. So what will happen when the value present in accumulator is rotated on left? This 0 will come to carry flag, this 1 present in carry flag will come to the LSB side, and all the bits, remaining bits, will be shifted on left side by 1 bit position. So the new value in accumulator will be B5 hex. So let us first of all make the value in accumulator as 5A hex, and now if I execute that instruction, I get here B5 hex, right? And you can see that the carry flag is 0. That is because the MSB bit present in accumulator is now copied to the carry flag. Next instruction is RRA. So RRA stands for rotate the value present in accumulator to the right side by 1 bit position. So again, let us assume that the value present in accumulator is 5A. So if the value present in accumulator is rotated on right side, so all the bits will be shifted to the right side. So this LSB bit of accumulator will be copied to MSB, and the remaining bits will be shifted by 1 bit position on right side. So the new value present in accumulator will be 2D hex. So let us execute the instruction. So we have got here 2D hex as the output. Next instruction is RRC. So again, this instruction is used to rotate the value present in accumulator to the right side by 1 bit position, but this time the value will be rotated through the carry flag. So here again, the value present in accumulator is 5A, and the carry flag that we have assumed is 0. So carry flag is already 0. So if I rotate the value on right side through carry, the carry contents of carry flag will be copied to the MSB bit position of accumulator, and the LSB bit position of accumulator will be copied to carry flag, and the remaining bits in accumulator will be shifted on right side by 1 bit position. So this carry flag will come to MSB, then this all bits will be shifted on right side by one bit position, and this 0 will be copied to the carry flag. So the again new value will be 2D hex. So that is the value. Next instruction is swap A. So using this instruction, upper nibble and lower nibble are swapped. So let us assume the contents in accumulator as 5A. So if the lower nibble and upper nibble are swapped, this lower nibble will be present at upper nibble position, and this upper nibble will be present at lower nibble position. So let us execute the instruction. So here we have got the value as A5, which is the swapped version of the previous value. So in this way, these instructions can be used to perform different logical operations on the value data present in accumulator. So all these instructions are of implied addressing mode, because only accumulator can be used as a operand. We cannot use any other register as a operand in these instructions. And all these instructions are of 1 byte, because only opcode is required for their representation. So this is about the logical instructions present in 8051. In the next video, we'll see the bit manipulation instructions present in 8051. Thank you.